Hello, Internet! My name is Abby, and welcome back to Take on Mars! In the last episode, I began to construct the two new rooms of the moon base, the toilet and my bedroom, and today I will continue constructing those two rooms, and yeah, so I can now, get stuck. Okay, I am, would you help? I am stuck between the couch and the table. Jump. Careful guy. Ha. Phew. Okay, I think the couch is a little bit too close to the table, so I think I will just move it a little bit back and install it again. Okay, what happens if I sit down now? Okay, I can still sit on the couch and here, yeah, okay, now is enough space in order to get up again. That's cool, that's really cool. Okay, now at first I just, these doors are really, really dangerous. Okay, I like to get into my shiny new hub system. And yeah, it says it's safe, so I can move in this direction. Because yeah, I really like to take a look at the progress I made in the last episode. So yeah, the space toilet is, well, we need to construct the lower part of the room. And unfortunately, the new bedroom will need some time in order to be finished. So yeah, I think I should head out again and start the construction of those two new rooms. Because yeah, at some point I really like to finish this. And yeah, I like to show you my shiny new moon base. And so yeah, I think I can now close all the doors. And I hope my suit has recharged as, yeah, we were down to less than 1 hour of oxygen left in the suit. So I think, yeah, the light is green. So now I can grab my suit again and I can get back into my heavy suit. Very nice. Okay, and now I can venture out. I can return to the surface of the moon. And okay, we need to print a lot of items and we need to install a lot of items. So yeah, the last episode was quite heavy on the construction, and I think this episode and probably even the next episode will also feature a lot of building, and I hope you will still like this because yeah, at some point I really like to finish my those two rooms so that we can then try out some new things as well I got on the episode with the forklift versus resource tank, I guess. I got two interesting suggestions. On the one hand, I got the suggestion that, well, maybe the fork raises fast enough so that in the end it will basically lift the object on the fork into the air. It will shoot this object into the air. And so maybe this will then give me enough time to drive the forklift to the side and to grab the object, but I'm not quite sure. I think this is a little bit, on the one hand, I'm not quite sure if the fork of the forklift has enough momentum in order to do this, and on the other hand, I'm not quite sure if I can really, shoot the thing into the air and then drive the forklift back. And jump out of the forklift and grab the resource tank before it will hit the ground again in order to assemble it. So yeah, I think in the end, if it's even possible to lift the thing into the air, then I don't think that I will be fast enough. But yeah, I still like to give it a try because yeah, I really like, and I'm really happy when I get suggestions from you and when I get some input or some ideas from you that sound cool. At some point, as I began the moon base, not the moon. Okay, now I have some issues over here before I can continue talking about that. What is your problem? item. What is your problem object? Why don't you like to be installed down there? Okay, do I need to maybe get it out and turn it around? Come on, easy, easy. Now turn it and down and now bring it in and come on. Indeed. No, no, no. I want you. Yes, yes. This is exactly what I wanted. Very good. The building process is slowed down by the building mechanic of Take on Mars, or well, not really the building mechanic, but the problem that it's often really hard to align the objects with the free slot. Okay, now I hope I can easy, easy, bring it in. No, I can't, because what, why this object is annoying. Okay, come on, now easy, get in there. That's why, yes, no. Okay, grab object and No, I don't want to add it like this to the moon base. Maybe if I do something like this, can I then bring it down? Easy. No, not up there, down there. Yeah. Wow. Okay. I need another corner and I was talking about something. Oh yeah, I was talking about the forklift idea. This could be funny, but at first, of course, I will do a test. I will try to launch a smaller object. And yeah, speaking about launching, at the beginning of the scenario, I got even a comment like I should try to drive one of the vehicles up a ramp in order to fly around and so on. I'm still not convinced if this is really fun in the end, so I'm not quite sure if I will do this. And yeah, then I got a very interesting comment or a very interesting suggestion regarding or concerning the installment of the of my favorite resource tank. And well, the idea is that I've showed you this many times, that once an item lies on a different or on another item, or even if I just turn around with an item in my hand, I can move or at least have an effect on very heavy items. And well, this is very interesting. And so the idea is that I should place the resource tank on on a flat surface, like such a, what's the thing called, a base platform, or however the thing is called, a large floor or so. And then I should try to lift the large floor in order to lift the resource tank, and while the resource tank is falling down, I should grab it and try to install it. Once again, I am also a little bit concerned with this idea, because shooting things in the air could have the tendency that those items will then just tip over and lie on the side, and then we have lost. But well, on the other hand, we have already lost, as I'm not able to install those stupid resource tanks. And in the end, I just wanted to say I got really interesting. No, I don't want to disassemble it. I want to grab the object. I got some very interesting suggestions, and I really like to give them a try and to see if they are maybe useful, so that we can find a way how we can install full resource tanks. This would be really, really interesting. And I'm looking forward to that. But at first, I like to finish my moon base. and maybe this was not the best way. Maybe I think, or maybe I should do things a little bit different with the bedroom. Maybe I should at first build the outer wall, the wall on the opposite side of the moon base, so that I I need four wall corners for the bedroom, so I can already start the production over here. What do I wanted to say? Oh yeah, maybe I should start to add all the components and all the objects on the opposite side of the moon base at first, because then I can still walk through the room. And right now I am still I'm all the time required to walk around. And okay, I only need two curved walls, and then I can start the production of the windows. That's good, that's really good. Okay, you can continue doing that. And I think I have to talk about this in, this episode or in this Let's Play series as well, because wait, there's something very interesting I'd like to address in just a moment, because I already talked about this in one of the last the Long Dark episodes. I need to break a little bit the fourth wall. Okay, now I need to talk about something. Look at the Earth. Look at the Earth. The Earth is just only a small crescent. That's interesting. That's really interesting. I think as we began the series, or as we began the scenario, we were able to clearly see the Earth. But, well, no, it's just a small crescent. That's very interesting. That's, wow, that's amazing. And I even think the light has changed down here, so the moon has rotated around, I guess. This is a little bit fast that the light is changing down here. But yeah, I have the slight feeling that soon we will get into the darkness or so. I'm not quite sure, but this is a little bit strange, because nighttime and daylight Earth is on the moon, not on our hour based. It's more week based, more or less. So I'm not quite sure if something went wrong with the moon. But I do have the feeling that really the time is, or that the sun is moving, and that's, oh, I need my tool. Okay. I was wondering why is nothing happening down there, but I just had not my tool active. Okay. So, I wanted to break down the fourth wall. I already spoke about this in one of the the Long Dark episodes. So, when I do, or when I record an episode of The Long Dark and of Take on Mars, in most of the cases I am not recording one episode. No, instead I'm playing the game for, let's say, an hour or so, or an hour and 20 minutes or so, and in the end I get three episodes out of one recording session. And the same thing also applies for most of the other games on my channel, except for Kerbal Space Program, as Kerbal Space Program needs so much planning and preparation. And of course my favorite coffee break with Debbie in Minecraft, because the coffee break is about things that happen in my life, and Yeah, so I can't record really coffee breaks in advance because I'm talking about things that happened in my life, and so I have no idea. I can't look into the future. I can't predict the future, so I can't record a coffee break for the next week or so. No, those two videos are mostly recorded in a single recording session. But yeah, Take on Mars and The Long Dark and etc. Corsa and so on are mostly recorded in a longer recording session. So it's really getting dark here. That's interesting. What do I wanted to say with this very long with my ramblings about my recording procedures? I record three episodes or so. And because most of my videos get released on a weekly basis, so I release one, as you might know, or I think you are already aware of this, I release one episode of Take on Mars per week. But you could be watching the first episode of a recording session, and yeah, I'm not able to really to reply to your input and your comments until the next recording session. And in this case, this might be a little bit interesting for you, but if you leave me a comment, I of course read all of your comments, and I am all the time so happy when I get a comment. And I just was a little bit distracted. I was thinking about, have I now installed those windows, those curved windows, in the wrong orientation? But no, it's the right orientation. This is good. And yeah, the exterior is safe. I just checked it with my spacesuit because I wanted to be sure that that there's no leak. And okay, now I can move on printing all those items. And yeah, so there's all the time the slight chance that it will take some time until I can really address your ideas and your comments in an episode. And yeah, let's just a little bit or some background information about how I am producing my videos. That most of them are of course recorded in a longish recording session, because it's a little bit easier for me to then deal with the footage and to render all the episodes and the on. And it's a little bit easier to schedule the recording sessions, because then I can say, okay, I'm now playing the game for an hour or so, and then I have time for other projects, and I don't need to remember, okay, now I have to record the next Take on Mars because it's already Monday or so. And some background information, and only, as I said, the coffee break and Kerbal Space Program are recorded in a single recording session, because sometimes I do multiple Kerbal Space Program episodes at once, but in most of the case, there's so much preparation involved that it's not really possible to record the episodes in advance. And of course, as I already said, my favorite coffee break, where I talk about my life, where I share all the things that happened in my life with you, they have to be recorded just before, on the day where I will release this, because otherwise I might just lose some important information or so. And now you know how I work, and I hope this was a little bit interesting for you, because I'm still all the time moving back and forth, and I'm carrying around items and objects. And when I look at the roof of, oh dear, a new solar event, I think we will end off the episode with the arrival of the next solar event. And because I don't think that I can finish my bedroom in this episode, but at least I was able to share some background information about how everything is working, how your favorite Take on Mars episodes are produced, and yeah, whatnot. All the exciting stuff that happens behind the scenes of our moon base and so on. And so far about that. No, I'm lost a little bit. I'm pressing all the time the same key. Okay, now I can bring over the corners. Can I already install the corner? No, not really. Okay, I can drop the corner there. And okay, there is this object. How should I do this at best? I think I will just leave this wall or this side open in order to bring all the materials into the room, and then I can install them from the inside. And well, I will then close this side of the bedroom once I have finished all the other walls, because then I just need only to walk for a couple of meters. And yeah, I think this is good. This is a good approach. And I need to bring over a corner to close the corner at the, well, right next to the entrance to the bedroom. Okay, now I can install that. Very nice. Now I can grab a corner. Wow, the crescent at the Earth is getting smaller and smaller. What is going on? On the one hand, if we sleep and take on Mars, then no time is passing by. But on the other hand, it seems that 1 minute on the moon is like a whole day in real life or so. That's crazy. That's really crazy. Oh dear, oh dear. Okay, what do I need to do now? I need to turn this around and very good, very good. So, only three curved walls and a corner, and then I am so far happy with the sides, and then I can start to print some curved windows to start adding some more or some objects to the roof. Okay, I said I need two curved walls, am I right? Yeah, two curved walls. And the corner should be ready. Okay, only 1 minute and 20 seconds until the solar event will take place. And yeah, so that's sad, that's really sad. I haven't finished the moon base, or I haven't finished the second room, but at least the space toilet is finished, and I'm really looking forward to the moment when both rooms are sealed and I can walk through the moon base, and we can explore the moon base and enjoy the moon base. I think this is then really, really cool. And okay, now I need to do something like this. Very good. Okay, I hope I can install the last curved wall, then the window, and the window, the corner, and then we can continue in the next episode with some curved windows. And I think it's possible. I think it's possible before the solar event will arrive. Okay, no. You are not running away. You are not running away, because you get now installed. Okay, very good. Ooh, only a couple of seconds. Run. We can make it. We can get into safety and close the door. Ha! Right in time. Okay, we are now safe. The exterior is safe. We are protected against the solar event. And yeah, with this, I think we have reached the end of this episode. I hope you have enjoyed this episode, and I hope you will be joining me in the next episode when we hopefully finish the bedroom of the moon base. And yeah, so in this case, thank you so much for watching. Until next time, my name is Abby. See you!